In this video, I'd like to show an example of optimization problem. Before starting an example, you need to know the following steps to solve the question. First of all, draw a picture of the scenario if you can. Step 1, formulate the objective function. Step 2, reduce the above objective function to one variable. Step 3, take the derivative of the function and find the critical values. Step 4, find the local max or mean by either first derivative or second derivative test, and check the endpoint to locate the max or mean. Let's take a look at the example. It is required to enclose a rectangular field by a fence and then divide into two lots by a fence parallel to the short side. If the area of the field is 600 square meter, find the length of the sides so that the total length of fence will be a minimum. Let's draw a picture based on the scenario. Minimize the total length, so the objective function should be the total length of fence. Step 1, find the total length function. Let W be the width and L be the length of the field. As you can see, there are three widths and two length sides in the field. Therefore, the total length should be T equal 3W plus 2L. Step 2. Since the above total length function has two variables, we need to reduce it to one variable. To do so, we need to use some information, which is the area of field at 600 square meter. Since the area of the field is 600 square meter, we can express length L equal to 600 divided by width W. L equal 600 over W. Or you could express that W equal 600 over L as well. Now, substituting L as 600 over W into the objective function in step 1 to get the total function as T equal 3W plus 2 times 600 over W. Simplifying the function to get T equal 3W plus 1200 over W. Step 3, taking the derivative and letting it be 0 to get the critical value, which is a possible minimum value. Changing the objective function form to take the derivative easier. We have now t equals 3w plus 1200w to the negative 1 power. Taking the derivative of the total function to get 3 minus 1200w to the negative 2 power, make the derivative be equal to 0 to find the critical values. Now we need to solve for w. Moving the 1200w to the negative 2 power term to the right, multiplying both sides by w squared, dividing by 3, and taking square root to get the critical values as plus or minus 20. Since the length cannot be negative, we eliminate the negative critical value. We have now the critical value as 20 meter, which is the possible minimum value. Step 4, As we found the possible minimum value W equal to 20 meter, we need to prove if it is indeed the minimum value by either first or second derivative test. I am showing the first derivative test here. Place the critical value on the line and make two intervals using it. Then select a test value for each interval. I chose 1 for the first interval and 30 for the second interval. Now, substituting the test value 1 into the derivative to get the sign as negative. Substituting another test value 30 into the derivative to get the sign of positive for the second interval. For the first interval, since the sign of the derivative is negative, the function is decreasing. For the second interval, the function is increasing because of positive derivative. Since the function is changing from decreasing to increasing at W equal 20, there is a local minimum at W equal to 20. And there is only one critical value in this question. W equal 20 makes the absolute minimum. We found the width 20 meter, which makes the total length minimum. Next, we need to find the length as well. We have the area equation in step 2 to find the length. Substituting W equal 20 into the equation to get the length as 30 meter. The widths of 20 meter and 30 meter lengths minimize the total length of the fence. For your reference, we can find the minimum total length 120 meter using the equation in step 1. Thank you for watching. See you next time.